he lost against Alchemist earlier today, previous getting pressured even when he farms on the tower here. Not the easiest time.
Even committing a bounty hunter TK to the bottom
CS right now. Very hard for him with Sumail being so aggressive.
Oh, Sumail, easy first blood.
Oh, you have to respect the long duration of Whirling Death.
Boba not really too afraid of any sort of harassment here, as Febby is only level 2. He's gonna start poking, still no boots up on 4-Ev, as the creeps are rather shoved in, and Sumail just having a field day in the mid lane. 13-6.
Bounty rune, at least, for Alchemists.
Gets the bounty. He's actually CSing okay, despite the first blood. Still 9-0.
Yeah.
And considering he gave that up, I think this build will come in handy now, looking towards the soul raid
again. Wow.
So, oh, killing the bottom lane. It kind of seems like a necessary adjustment. You can't just play full greed mode and hope that Sumail, probably like top 3 most aggressive mids in the world when he's at his best, and
he does
this have... is a game where he's going to be aggressive.
Yeah, he does have good luck with the bounty rune. Oh, dust on Febby here as the fear comes in. They should be able to force a kill here. He's trying to go for Ancients tonight.
Yeah, will he get it? There's the heal bomb, but Sumail has the whirling death. He grabs it. Oh, maybe losing the courier.
Some splash damage from the big...
So the one guy who ultimately has struggled a bit here looks to be Aoi. Still level 4, closing on 5 at 7.5 minutes. Did try lane, but oh, as I say that, they're going to catch up for him. Big kill on the bottom lane. Slaughter not going to be able to slow
their way. Struggling, let's just give you a kill.
And meanwhile, Sumail doing Sumail things.
Solo kill onto
this Slaughter, or this Timbersaw is going to be a problem.
Yeah. Well, Slaughter is still struggling to finish up his Blink Dagger, trying to get to that point. Of course, same thing is going on for the Batrider.
Dubu, no. Mid lane, deleted.
Just standing there waiting for him, just about to delete you soon. And in comes the Alchemist, but he can't really do too much.
The Vlads now, but they're Radiant, so they will need to take down this bottom tier 1 at the very least if they want to try for a Roche. And MVP, now with the Invest Bomb ready. They have only the one armlet, the other one not delivered just yet. And they actually drop but just a random sentry. They're going to find Febby. This is awkward. You're going to need to leave. Get out of here, FP. He's like, oh god, where have I gone? But he will manage to get that free kill on Bulba on the way out. Is Aoi chasing out QO?
Not too far to die. Was doing there. He got caught out a little bit. There was a lot of wards, so getting juked again. Old man fear. Can't keep up with this fish.
Yeah, Febby slither too fast. Slowly working in to try and deliver this payload, and it's on to Sumail. He walks right into the clutch, into three heroes, even with the max reactive armor. No chance in hell he survives. MVP.
G now, suddenly on the ropes here against MVP, who have a lot of farm between their cores. All of them are going really poor.
They got that one kill, 2,000 gold lead, and they're going to find more. PPD, tracked up, Chainfall's coming through, he does get the grave up though. This could be a huge turnaround for EG with the Magnetize going. Can they finish anyone off? 4F, going to mash him down. Febby is going to fall though as the trade. A 2-for-1, Dupu going for the TP out, he's going to make it, and now MP's in, onto the old man, 4F back as well, just banging on Aoi. They're going to bring this wolf down. Unless Sumail can turn it, and it looks like he'll try. Moving on to QO, but has the Chemical Rage. He should be okay. Actually has the Sacred Relic as well, and
he does have his Radiance. It's coming in.
Full Radiance. Alchemist.
I think they need big plays now from Bulba and Aoi. I think Aoi, he's underfarmed, so he needs to recover this Necrobook. But look at the Infest Bombs. They're so aggressive, he won't be able to farm up if he gets ganked here.
They're kind of expecting this one, though. The whole team's on top of Aoi. EG looking to turn this right back the other way. They do grave Aoi. MP getting caught out, but there's the Chain Frost again. Lopped in, it somehow bounces a Bulba, then the PPD. Now MVP need to run, though, because Sumail's here on cleanup duty. Slaughters two. A 2-for-1. He's looking for that third. Is he going to find it on the backside for Ev? Tanking the Magnetize, likely to go down, pops the stick. He's got the infused raindrops. Will they be enough to save him from the magic damage? No, siree, EG. They make it a 3-for-1. They fully read that smoke.
Yeah, definitely. They were pretty. Yes, friends coming in, though.
It's going to jump past him, but yeah, they're packing it.
So close.
They're packing heat, but meanwhile, Lasso coming onto QO, who wanted that bounty rune. Sure looks tasty. He's going to stun himself. Could be in trouble now. They're going to follow this up with the Magnetize. QO dropping very quickly the Chemical Rage. Not there, and EG will get a crucial kill on the Alchemist.
Trying to stick together and use the power they have of counter-ganking.
How confident are you in EG trying to take a fight against the Sages? Do you think that's something that they consider doing now, or do you just look to trade and dodge?
It depends if they get a pick. Actually,
speaking of which, they do find one, and then the real action breakout mid is they get the last one, Dubu, to follow this up. So Lifestealer connecting for a kill there in the top lane with the help of the Slardar and a Fest Bomb onto the Lycan. The trade so far, only the Lich, but Sumail going deep for this. He really wants the Febby kill. He's in quite far. He's going to have to chain away, but they go into pursuit. The Alk's done revving up, and he's going to have a chance to let it go. Here comes the Infest Bomb. Oh, he touches a bit early. It's okay, though. MVP still collecting their Sumail kill, who had the Bloodstone Suicide, did not opt to use it there.
Yeah, definitely should have. He just forgot. Sometimes he misclicked. Oh.
Nice, they're diving here, deeper. Though. They look for PPD. They get the bash as well. Grape does come through. The kick connects onto Fibby, almost killing him on the back lines. Gotta hope that tower doesn't change targets, but PPD still being pursued. The long range lob. There's the Alk stun. He jams it in.
The Radiant's gonna get it. They're gonna back out now, though. MVP, though.
They're all aggressive. You gotta be careful, like, TPing into the front lines against MVP. Any moment, they might just see you and just run at you at 1% HP. 6,000, probably closer to 7,000 gold advantage, a 3,000 experience lead, and some tools to deal with Sumail.
Tools to deal with him, but they also got an important kill on him when he just finished up his Bloodstone. And here to go again.
There's the crush, the turnaround comes, MP's there, they bring down Bulba. MVP getting a follow-up track, now Chain Frost lobbed in, 4F just looking for that crush. The Chain Frost, not the best, but they do get the crush on Sumail. Still waiting for their Alchemist to arrive, and finally the prized hero has QO joins the fray. So they're in the power play now. Sumail says, screw it. I'm a one-man wrecking crew. He runs right into the enemy squad. But MP wants to re-engage on this, and Sumail's got to be careful not to overextend. There's the stun, though. They kind of ignore him, bypass him, and look for the back lines. On to Aoi they go. They're going to bring down the Lycan with ease, and now they turn back for Fear. Fear gets silenced up. Fear gets brought down. That's another track kill, and still QO dies right past Sumail. On to PPD, butchering the back lines, and landing kill after kill. QO finds himself now 3-2-3. But it could be more. They have a blink cooling down suit. They don't have the mana for a crush, though.
MVP will end it ever here. So aggressive. And it's really sad to watch this Timbers, though. He just cannot save his allies. QO going in, slaughtering them in front of his eyes. They're going to save it for him. That's pretty far. But probably they are. He wants all of them.
Wow. You said you called it, Waga. Well, QO going to get caught out here. This could be a big grab on the Alchemist. As the Chemical Rage still going, but don't know if it's going to matter. He turns, he lobs out a stun.
He doesn't have AD.
He does manage to purchase the Octarine. Even if he goes down, won't lose gold, but will give up a hell of a lot to EG. He's tanky, though, and MP arrives. The Cavalry comes from the rear. QO's got backup. He's got track as well. There's a Haste Brew lurking in the river, but Sumail won't be allowed to get it. Fear's likely to be next. 4F just lurching forward. They bring down three. They're looking for the fourth. EG slaughtered. Time after time, they hemorrhage the kills, and Fear, the old man who once dominated this game, it's but a blip on the radar for MVP. The slight lead, it looks like totally insignificant now.
It's been
4F with the number of kills and track gold acquisitions that he's managed to pile up thus far.
He's close to BKB, yeah.
He might get it.
Nice.
But MVP may also just end this game before it even gets to that point. Dubu slow sieging the bottom towers of Lich. But more importantly, it's 4F. Bam! With the two hero cuts. Then the silence of the PPD. Great focus here from MVP as they'll grab two more. MP cool under pressure. And while that was happening, they also just kill the tower bottom. This Lich played so confidently.
He's not making Aoi run either. The silence? Is it there? But they don't have it. But
not even going to bother. It feels like there's just no hope for EG. GG. They call it here. One game away now from starting with Secret in the lower bracket.
I told you, man, MVP, they don't tire. They don't get exhausted. They just played a super long game, crazy stuff going down. They're like, it's fine. We'll just play one more and crush it.
EG had to wait a long time to play this game one. And MVP, they come in hot. They come in focused. They just shrugged off that lane warmish
at some point.
Depends Aoi,
how good of a game they have on
time being.
Stack the Ancients pretty hard, it
and
seems.
Fear is not going to allow that.
Yeah, they've been clearing the trees a lot, so they want to rely on it, but Fear has two sentries. Febby only has one. So even Fear, if he dewards this one, he's not going to be able to get the second one off.
Yeah, Fear already planting that sentry. There's the deward. Very quickly deployed just out of range as Fear will have to charge out, but the Flame Break already skilled up to interrupt this. This might be the first blood.
He's dead.
Who skills Flame Break at level 2, says Fear?
I do, says MP.
It's where you're contemplating your life as a first blooded support.
And I got,
all right. Where did it all go wrong, Waka? How do I turn this around?
He's so far back. That's going to be really hard to kill.
And Bristleback is going to have a lot of time to stack up the quills, so even if they get the kill on Febby, he may just punish PPD on the way out, who has zero armor. They're going back in. The vaunted Bristle IO duo as Febby still has stick charges, still has the Tango. Going to muscle his way up on Fear. Does have the charge, but again, having to commit these defensively. It's going to be really painful. Looks like they looked for the Sunstrike, but they didn't find it on Febby.
They're going
to kill him to move forward. Owie could go down. Oh, they're going to back off.
Gonna respect the tower a little bit. Just MVP. You cannot underestimate the Wisp play from these guys. They know exactly how to use it.
And now Febby getting charged along with the Sunray. This time it may be a bridge too far. He tethers in, but 4F gonna quickly lose his little buddy though. He is very big right now. The quill stacking up. Fear has no charge. He's running in on PPD. He might get a twofer here. He can hit Fear once more with the quills. He gets him as well. He's looking for the triple. Owie driven back off the lane. But that's without the IO, who's
mana
free fountain. Let's go.
He's like, okay, I want to keep using my spell, so I'm going to go mana boots. Why not?
I mean, how do you recover from this game? Owie has the level one chain.
He's dead.
He's dead anyway. There is no saving this man. Timber's going home. So too might EG down to the lower bracket. This
God.
How do you salvage this start? Gone for the early Helm of Iron Will. Bulba getting his levels. He is four. Not too shabby for sub 4 minutes, but I look at this top lane and I just see continuous disaster written all over it.
Yeah, charges coming in, but they're so healthy right now. How do you bring them down? Bottle charges, magic wand.
They're going to try for it though. 4F gets caught. The Sunray doing work. Febby's got to keep his buddy alive. If he goes down, this could be the start of the comeback. But he jukes into the trees. Kill that little ball. Kill it. They can't. They try with the chain. It's off the mark, and now 4F going to come in. There's the swoop, but PPD also needing to get out at the same time as Owie desperately tries to finish the job. This armadillo simply won't die. He even moves forward, just lurching in after Owie. The goose spam continues. He doesn't have the chain in time, and this is a tri lane. Remember that. Yeah, this is a tri lane.
Tri lane status going great. Doesn't even have boots as well.
There will be no chrono available, so they are going to need a clean initiation, though.
Charge him? Oh, charge is very late.
He is going to commit to this one. The cask, does he get it off in time? Sunstrike coming through. It's a direct hit at long last.
Nice combo.
EG finally get a kill.
EG need to get on board with the kills here for everyone, really.
Now, at the same time, they see that rotation bottom. They say, great, we're going to kill Owie top. If anyone comes, we'll kill you too. He tries to chain away. He's got no TP. He does have the stick charges, though, but with the amount of heals that this IO is pumping into the armadillo, I'm
they
not sure it's going to matter.
Not
gotta be
him.
Careful.
They should honestly not right-click him when they try to kill him, because he has 3 points in the reactive armor, and they can kill him with just the stick, the quill spray. But when they hit him like this, his armor goes up.
And they might get Febby here too. MVP, they've miscalculated. They've given up two costly kills. They might even give up to 4F1 though. He's a bit tankier, already has the Ring of Health. Moving back in, this actually forced Sumail to bring... And they are slowly rising to their feet, but something that can knock them back down is about to arrive. It's the Blink Dagger for MP. As three heroes converge on the top lane,
Boy,
the Haste Rune is up on the bat as well. Boyd's got the Chrono, he catches out Dubu. It's a great one for Bulba, but Febby is there, keeping 4F alive for a long time. The charge does come through, though, and 4F will fall, and now the chase is on. EG looking for more. The bat comes from the rear. He's going to drag the Jumpman down to the low ground. Still, it's a 2-for-1 thus far. Sumail, in a lot of trouble, has stick charges hanging onto the page. But Bulba's moving in. MP juking a bit up to the tree lane. Can they lock him down? There's the time walk forward. They actually lost the Invoker. He roasted in the flames. Bulba getting juked as MP runs rings around him, just stacking up the napalm. It forces out another Phoenix TP top.
S4 rune, dude. It's pretty good on Batrider.
And he's got the blink ready, so she'll be able to make it out. And this is before the Slardar gets involved.
Scan just saying, yes, there are four stacks, sir.
Yeah. Well, originally, apparently, it was going to get Vision, is the rumor that we heard today. That started to get good. There was like a golden age of just running to carry in every lane. The Tricore strat.
And it's very hard to do good smokes as well. And here goes the flame break, just perfect.
They find Sumail, but the Chrono's there. It's a beauty from Bulba. Catching out three from MVP. It's up to Febby to save this. QO, though, has the armlet. He's tanky. They bring out PPD. Owie on the run with MP on the chase. Can they finish off this Timber? They've got the magic damage to bring him down. QO with the toggles. Oh, no, EG. They gotta get out. They can't deal with that angry fish, man.
No.
The sushi wakes up and starts eating.
QO will not die.
The sushi lover.
All right, straight into Roche. Seems to be the call here. They have great heroes against it. Walk right into the pit, but they're kind of far.
Sunstrike with a Sunray, they could maybe stop them from this. Nope. A dive to steal?
Is he going for PPD? Feeling desperate. He drops the egg outside the pit, but MVP can shrug it off, or they can just maybe kill him. QO, he chooses the aggression method, but PPD does get the egg off. Have they baited him in? He manages to toggle the armlet on again. Is he going to get it off and on once more? Yes, he does. QO staying alive for way too long. Finally, they will connect and find the kill, but MP had another lasso. He brings down the Spirit Breaker again. Space Cow out of the fight, and QO back in the picture, hunting to the right, looking for Bulba.
Peter running for his life.
He'll amp one. But they'll chase down that Firebird. He went for the desperation play. Does match to crack the Aegis nice and early, but it still costs them another 2-for-1.
I think they're actually struggling so hard in this game that he's not there.
Where is that carry potential gonna come from?
It's all on Sumail at this point. He has to bring some amazing team fights.
They have to hit the perfect combo, and they're gonna move towards these Ancients. Are they risking a fight into it? That is a bold move. As Aoi hunts Dubu down to the river, the Chrono goes the other way. A bit of a disjointed fight from EG, but they do dump the damage onto Febby. Mech's there to keep the Io alive, will eventually fall, and now PPD dropping the egg in the middle of the enemy squad. It's a really good fight by EG. They gotta kill this egg up. They're kind of late to do so. MP doesn't get it in time. Dubu gets stunned by the egg. Actually, an immaculate fight by EG, but then the crush. QO again, trying to save the day. He gets up another armless toggle, again in the midst of the entire enemy squad. AG, even when it's perfect, it's shit. It's just not good enough.
I don't know what to say.
Yafetz is just turning over in his grave right now.
I'm just feeling
it's
that.
It's just too far behind for EG. These have been godly from PPD. It's still a level 1 egg, mind you, and they've got physical damage, or rather, attack speed to kill that quickly. He's still getting them off every fight. They've got the Timber Cell damage on top, and they're still losing these fights.
They're getting grabbed.
There's the lasso onto Sumail. They're going to drag him back far away from the confines and safety of his home. Down he goes. They do manage to counterplay this, though, killing off the Witch Doctor. But now 4F and MP are into the back lines. That's before Big Daddy slaughtered our lives, and QO's just waiting. He finds the two-hero crush. Always on target. Fear down. How are we likely to be next? Up to the high ground, frantically back towards the well, but that's where 4F's going to hurt him. All immediately Fear rejoining this one. Oh, he TP's in. He's got no charge. I think they know it, too. They're going deeper for Bulba. It's time to leave the game. Your run's over. They call it now. It's EG and it's Secret both down to the lower bracket. The Koreans are on top. Eternal Envy called it, but I don't think he expected the story to go quite this way.
No, definitely not. And congrats to MVP going into the winner bracket, not having to go into that best of one in the lower bracket first round. Really scary stuff for EG now as they join, as you say, Secret and EG down there.